Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Have mercy on me, O God, for people assail me. They fight me all day long and oppress me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we come in this Eucharistic celebration celebrating God's action of saving us, of forgiving us. And so to prepare ourselves for this sacrament of salvation, let us first acknowledge our sins and humbly ask the Lord for His pardon and strength. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, by whose wondrous grace we are enriched with every blessing, grant us so to pass from former ways to newness of life, that we may be made ready for the glory of the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. The assembly condemned Susanna to death, but Susanna cried aloud, "O eternal God, you know what is hidden and are aware of all things before they come to be. You know that they have testified falsely against me. Here I am about to die, though I have done none of the things with which these wicked men have charged me." The Lord heard her prayer. As she was being led to execution, God stirred up the Holy Spirit of a young boy named Daniel, and he cried aloud, "I will have no part in the death of this woman." All the people turned and asked him, "What is this you are saying?" He stood in their midst and continued, "Are you such fools, O children of Israel, to condemn a woman of Israel without examination and without clear evidence? Return to court, for they have testified falsely against her." Then all the people returned in haste. To Daniel, the elders said, "Come, sit with us and inform us, since God has given you the prestige of old age." But he replied, "Separate these two far from each other, that I may examine them." After they were separated one from the other, he called one of them and said, "How you have grown evil with age. Now have your past sins come to term, passing unjust sentences, condemning the innocent, and freeing the guilty. Although the Lord says, the innocent and the just you shall not put to death. Now then, if you were a witness, tell me, under what tree you saw them together?" "Under a mastic tree," he answered. Daniel replied, "Your fine lie has cost you your head, for the angel of God shall receive the sentence from him and split you in two." Putting him to one side, he ordered the other one to be brought. Daniel said to him, "Offspring of Canaan, not of Judah, beauty has seduced you. Lust has subverted your conscience. This is how you acted with the daughters of Israel, and in their fear they yielded to you. But a daughter of Judah did not tolerate your wickedness. Now then, tell me, under what tree you surprised them together?" "Under an oak," he said. Daniel replied, "Your fine lie has cost you also your head, for the angel of God waits with a sword to cut you in two so as to make an end of you both." The whole assembly cried aloud, blessing God who saves those who hope in him. They rose up against the two elders, for by their own words, Daniel had convicted them of perjury. According to the law of Moses, they inflicted on them the penalty they had plotted to impose on their neighbor. They put them to death. Thus was innocent blood spread that day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures, he gives me repose. Beside restful waters, he leads me. He refreshes my soul.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side, with your rod and your staff that give me courage.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side.
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. Please stand.
Sinabi ng buong mahal, di ko nais na mamatay ang mga makasalanan. Nagbabagong kalooban upang sila ay mabuhay.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went to the Mount of Olives, but early in the morning, he arrived again in the temple area, and all the people started coming to him, and he sat down and taught them. Then the scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery and made her stand in the middle. They said to him, "Teacher, this woman was caught in the very act of committing adultery. Now in the law, Moses commanded us to stone such women. So what do you say?" They said this to test him so that they could have some charge to bring against him. Jesus bent down and began to write on the ground with his finger. But when they continued asking him, he straightened up and said to them, "Let the one among you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her." Again he bent down and wrote on the ground, and in response, they went away one by one, beginning with the elders. So he was left alone with the woman before him. Then Jesus straightened up and said to her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" She replied, "No one, sir." Then Jesus said, "Neither do I condemn you. Go, and from now on, do not sin anymore." Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
We hear in the two stories of our celebration today the action of God and the action of man. In the two stories, we hear the action of man is to accuse, to condemn. But the action of God is always to save. In the first reading, we hear about the story of Susanna, who was falsely accused and condemned to death. But we see the action of God to Daniel. He was inspired by God so that he could say that, "I will not have part in spilling innocent blood, because of your false accusation, because of your condemnation. And so Daniel was inspired by God to act. It was the action of God to save. People falsely accused, people condemned to death, but God saves us from all of these. And this is also what we hear in our story in the gospel. When God saves Jesus, saves the woman caught in adultery from being condemned to death by stoning. So again, we see the difference between the action of man and the action of Jesus. The action of man is to condemn to death, but Jesus saves so that he could spare us from death and give us life. Sa dalawang kwento po na ito ay makikita natin ang pagkakaiba palagi ng gawain ng Diyos at gawain ng tao. Ang gawain ng tao ay manghusga at magbigay ng paghuhusga sa isang tao. Pero ang Diyos ay laging hindi nang huhusga, hindi nagpaparusa, kundi nagliligtas sa atin. My dear brothers and sisters, it seems that after a year, we have gone full circle and we have gone back to our situation last year. So I am celebrating this Mass with just a few people here who are helping us, help us in our readings, the ones who are helping us with the broadcasting of this Mass. And I felt like it is as if we are back to 2020. And it is sad that we are celebrating Masses again without the congregation, without you. And people will easily say, you can easily say na, bakit naman pinaparusahan na naman tayo ng Diyos? No? Parang madaling isipin yan. When you see people suffering, when we see churches closed, when we see Masses celebrated only through broadcast online, we can easily say, Lord, why have you done this to us? Why are you punishing us? Why are you condemning us? My dear brothers and sisters, let us be reminded, it is not God who accuses. It is not God who punishes. Our sins, our evil deeds are condemning us, are punishing us. It is human work to condemn and to punish, but it is God's work to save. So my dear brothers and sisters, in this time of our pandemic, in this time that we are back again to celebrating Mass in closed churches, let us look at this situation not as a punishment from God, but let us see the hand of God working to save us. Sana po ngayong mga panahon na ito na tayo ay sinusubok ng ating pandemya na ito, ay makita natin ang kamay ng Diyos. Ang Diyos na hindi humuhusga, ang Panginoong Diyos na hindi nagpaparusa, kundi ang Panginoong Diyos na patuloy na ginagawa ang kanyang pagliligtas sa atin. Let us pray to our God of salvation, to Jesus, the one who was sent to save us, let us pray that God will continue His work of salvation in our world today. Amen.
Please stand.
With confidence, let us now raise our hearts to God the Father, who guides us through His Word. For every petition, let us say, Father, keep us in your love.
Father, keep us in your love.
That those alienated from God through sin may experience the living mercy of the Savior. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us in your love.
That we may refrain from passing judgment on others, but look instead at our own lives in the eyes of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us in your love.
That all those weighed down by hardship and worry may realize that God is never far away from them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us in your love.
That the Lord may strengthen those who have been unjustly accused. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us in your love.
That the deceased may find happiness and peace in God's embrace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, keep us in your love.
Heavenly Father, help us to be forgiving toward people who treat us badly. May we show them the same compassion that your Son Jesus extended to the woman caught in adultery. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that preparing to celebrate the holy mysteries, we may bring before you as the fruit of bodily penance a joyful purity of heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received the heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty. Since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Broderick, our administrator, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Act of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Strengthened by the blessing of your sacraments, we pray, O Lord, that through them we may constantly be cleansed of our faults, and by following Christ, hasten our steps upward toward you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We thank you for joining us in this celebration through our online streaming of this Mass, and we will continue our regular schedule of online Mass. And we hope that you would continue to join us in this time that we are not able to physically gather. But we continue to pray also for the safety of everyone, especially our frontliners, our medical and health workers. And we pray that your families, your loved ones are all safe and protected. Let us continue to pray for healing and strength, So that we could be ready in celebrating the holy mysteries of the Passion, Death, and Resurrection of our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Set free from their sins, O Lord, we pray, the people who call upon you, that living a holy way of life, they may be kept safe from every trial. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Until the end, to your nation, Lord, we give our